In BC, there are thousands of kilometers of roads that now lead nowhere. These roads were built in the service of a goal, pushing further with the understanding that there could be a big payoff at the other end. When the investment money dries up, the crews go home and the road is often abandoned. These abandoned roads can become highways for predators and ATVs. This puts pressure on the wildlife populations, particularly mountain caribou. Our work is focused on removing these abandoned roads through restoration to facilitate the return of these roads to a mature forest environment. I'm Sean Rapai. I'm an ecologist, Machucho Environmental.
I'm Shantanu Dutt. I'm a terrestrial ecologist, Machucho Environmental.
And my name is Caroline Walter. I work for Machucho Environmental. I'm an environmental scientist and the GIS lead.
Back this year, in summer 2022, and we really want to understand how well the treatments and on the ground work we did last year, how well it worked, and if we achieved the desired outcomes we were after. Are we accelerating the return of the road to a forested environment? Are we slowing or eliminating the use of the road by predators? Are caribou using the road, or are people using the road, hunters or hikers? This monitoring program allows us to track the trajectory of the recovery and also the trajectory of our planted seedlings. We can better understand at what point we've met our reclamation goals. Yeah, pretty excited to see what we have on these cameras. There's not a lot of shots. Some of these cameras have 120, 150 photos, so I'm hoping that those are good, efficient shots. Very excited. So now with the reclamation work doing, especially with the rough and loose work that we've done, I think we're expecting to see little or no people whatsoever using the road, and hopefully few predators. And maybe if we're lucky, we'll see some caribou, but really we're trying to limit the use of the road by both people and predators. And that's gonna benefit caribou, but also other ungulates in the area, if it could be moose, caribou. With this project, we have incorporated several different treatments to achieve our restoration objectives. This includes using both functional and ecological restoration techniques. On the lower section of road, we use an excavator to decompact and recontour the road surface. This work was completed in 2021, and this year, we are back to monitor the success of the treatments. The rough and loose treatment has held up really well. This is exactly the condition we hope to see, and the mounds are actually holding water. These mounds are providing a variety of microsites, are holding moisture, and are supporting the establishment and growth of native seed rain and our planted seedlings. The coarse woody debris and felled trees are adding further complexity, providing ecosystem benefits that you don't get with more traditional restoration practices that use smooth surfaces. In this case, messy is good. We've also established monitoring sites along this road, where we take measurements that will allow us to evaluate the trajectory and success of the restoration efforts. We have a camera located at each site, but we are also collecting information on the survival and health of our planted seedlings, the percent cover of vascular plants, and the density and height of the woody shrubs that have established. Changes in these variables over time will tell us just how well the restoration is working. For example, as a road returns to its natural state, we will expect to see an increase in the establishment of native species through seed rain, and an increase in the abundance and height of woody shrubs, both planted and those that have seeded naturally. We are also monitoring the condition of our felled trees over time. We drop trees strategically along this road because this does a particularly good job of disrupting sight lines and will hopefully reduce the travel speed of predators and humans.
This is the DJI multispectral drone. It has a multispectral camera with 6 sensors that capture images in the visual and near-infrared spectrum. Each pixel in the images hold a reflectance value, which is a measure of the amount of light reflected from the object below. While programming the flight path, we have to carefully consider things such as image resolution, elevation gain or loss, and tree heights, and choose a flight altitude that balances these factors. Once the survey is complete, we download, organize, and backup the data to prepare it for processing. We use photogrammetry software to process the drone's images. Then we create aerial maps, or orthomosaics, of the survey areas, models of the ground surface, and calculate NDVI. 10 years ago, drones were a novel tool. Now they're just part of the standard toolkit within our industry.
The drone is a complement to our field vegetation monitoring. The imagery from the drone allows us to make an aerial map of sections of the road, and the multispectral camera allows us to calculate the normalized difference vegetation index, or NDVI, of the mapped sections. NDVI provides information on ground cover and vegetation health and productivity. Over time, the NDVI values change to reflect changes in vegetation on the ground. Monitoring NDVI from drone imagery allows us to document changes in vegetation over a large area and provides information on whether the site is achieving the restoration targets or if intervention is needed. All of the data gathered by the drone is geo-referenced, so we can relate what we see in the aerial maps and NDVI to what we see on the ground. Results from this year's monitoring will directly inform and help us refine our road restoration work moving forward. So far, as part of the Chase Caribou Road Restoration Program, we have restored more than 30 kilometers of abandoned mineral access roads in this area. Overall, we believe that strategically restoring these very remote, abandoned roads that run from valley bottom to the tops of mountains is a cost-effective way to reduce the pressures on caribou and other ungulates in the region.